Good evening, Wesley Church. It's Pastor Justin. It's Monday, June 15th, and I am bringing you tonight's daily devotion. I don't know if, based on the sounds and the sights around me, you can tell where I'm at, but I'm actually laying in a hammock in my backyard. It is such a beautiful day out, and it would be a waste to not sit out here and enjoy it a little bit today. We recently purchased this hammock to add to the backyard because, well, we're spending so much more time at home, and it seems only right to do some of our work from outside. And I got to tell you, it's been really great to be able to be productive and maybe do some reading or do some prepping for some sermons or Bible studies that are upcoming from this spot. But it's also a great place to relax a little bit, which is the topic of tonight's daily devotional. You know, it's actually a scriptural imperative direct from God that we take some time each week and relax. And we know that in the Bible, relaxation is actually called Sabbath. And we know that one of the earliest accounts of an order for Sabbath is actually found way back in the Old Testament in Deuteronomy when Moses brings down the Ten Commandments to the people. This is actually tonight's scripture verse, and it comes from Deuteronomy 5, 12 through 15. Let me read those words to you from the New International Version. Observe the Sabbath day by keeping it holy, as the Lord your God has commanded you. 6 days you shall labor and do all your work, but the seventh day is a Sabbath to the Lord your God. On it you shall not do any work, neither you nor your son or daughter, nor your male or female servant, nor your ox, your donkey, or any of your animals, nor any foreigner residing in your towns, so that your male and female servants may rest as you do. Remember that you were slaves in Egypt, and that the Lord your God brought you out of there with a mighty hand and an outstretched arm. Therefore the Lord your God has commanded you to observe the Sabbath day. Of course, this is a good reminder of why the Sabbath is such an important thing. It's not only is it important because we're to worship God on that day, but it's an important thing because it's a day for us to give rest, not only to ourselves, but to those that we care for, those that are under us in terms of work and order, but also those that we love, our family members and our friends. It's so important that we take some time to just rest because it allows us to recuperate for the work that is ahead in the work week. I want to offer that to you today as a suggestion that if you are one of those people, like many of the people I know, including myself sometimes, that likes to work, it's so important that you take some time to just relax. Take some downtime, take some Sabbath, and find some time for you to reconnect with God and just sit and enjoy God's peace and God's creation around you. That's my offering for you tonight. Relax, friends. It's important for your soul, for your body, and for your mind, that you do so from time to time. So take some time tonight, spend some time with God, maybe find a hammock of your own, and spend some time in prayer. Let's do that together before we go. Gracious God, thank you for giving us time in our work week to get all of our work done. We also praise you for having foresight when you created this world, to spend some time and giving us time at the end of the work week to relax and to recover and to spend time with just you. Lord, we pray tonight that we didn't have time this last weekend to get some relaxing in, would you give us some time tonight to do just that, to spend some time giving our bodies and our minds rest, but also spending some time with our souls connected to you. Lord, we come to you tonight for just a brief respite, knowing full well that you intend to give us rest. Thank you, God, for your great love for us. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Congregation, go get some rest. We'll see you tomorrow.